Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. Last time, we've obtained the second sword of the game, along with our companion Fee, the sword spirit, and achieved our green tunic. Or rather, obtained our green tunic. I apologize for my improper grammar at times. However, we are here to set off and begin our journey. Alas, before we do go, Fledge, he has something for us. That green uniform looks so adventurous, you sure look like a knight now. The headmaster said you're heading out to look for Zelda. You're really something else, I can never imagine myself doing what you're about to do. I put a lot of work into making this, you should take it with you. And we get the adventure pouch. With this, we gain 4 inventory slots. It's for adventures because it's neat and you can fit 4 things in it that you'll need on your big journey. You can buy all kinds of stuff at the bazaar and you can put it in this pouch. You should go look. You can buy some potions and a shield. They fit in the pouch and they might come in handy on an adventure. Link, I just know you'll find Zelda for us. Yes, indeed. However, we haven't gone to the bathroom the entire time we've been here. At the very least, we need to at least once. Yeah. Before going on an adventure, every hero must drop a deuce. And he's even kind enough to flush. However, as we see here, we have 4 slots here in our adventure pouch. If we hold down the B button later, we'll have another section of items. We can carry up to 16 things, 8 regular items from dungeons and whatnot, and the other 8 for miscellaneous things like shields and potions and medals and stuff. However, before we go to the shops, talk to the instructor. I heard a news link. Zelda has fallen down through the clouds. You're going to look for her. Is that right? The headmaster told me there's land beneath the clouds. Do you know anything about that? So that's the famous sword. Ah, but it won't do you much good if you don't have a shield to protect yourself with. Here, take this with you. And we get our free shield. The wooden shield is light and maneuverable, but it's also the weakest of all shields. Also, keep in mind that it's particularly vulnerable to fire. If it breaks, you can buy a new one at the bazaar. To equip the shield, hold the minus button and point it at the Wii remote. If you're not sure how to use the shield, Knight Commander Igas of the Barring Hall will happily teach you. Like he said, hold the minus button and equip. Shields have a stamina bar, or a health bar, meaning that once they run out of health, you're kind of screwed. As of earlier, we were able to show that we can throw things normally, or, if we can, we can bowl them! You can't get more awesome than bowling jars. Master, I have an update regarding the stone tablet and the resulting column of light. A column of light has appeared in the south of our location. Signs indicate that it has created an opening cloud barrier, blah blah blah, he told us this yesterday. Also caution that descending to the surface only armed with a sword will result in decreased probability of survival. Fee, I have a shield. If you have not already done so, I advise purchasing a shield and potions at the bazaar in preparation for our journey. Another subject to discuss. Once you are accustomed to the controls, you are free to modify the on-screen interface. This is what I've been waiting for. On the gear screen, select the interface and change the on-screen display to suit your preference. Gear swap button. 1. Good. See that? Going pro. That's just been bugging me the entire time. I hate that ugly interface. It just looks so ugly. I prefer this. It's clean. It just gives me the game with the things up at the top left. That's what I prefer. That's what I like. I prefer to keep it that way. However, as I've stated before, we go to gear. On hero mode, you retain all the treasures you've collected and insects that you have found. That's all you get to keep. However, since we're here now on hero mode, I'm going to upgrade my shield. upgrade gear. And we're going to upgrade our shield. It requires one Monster Claw, two Amber Relics, which are abundant, and one Jelly Blob. And it costs 30 rupees to upgrade. Go for it! I'd like my upgraded shield. Upgrading equipment, essentially for me right now, would be technically cheating, but you know what? I don't care. This is my playthrough. I'm playing it how I want to play it. You got a problem with it? Get out. And we've upgraded our wooden shield to the banded shield. It's more durable than the standard shield. And it looks nicer, too. We can upgrade shields a total of 2 times, but I don't have necessary items to upgrade it again. However, I hate the best designs for most shields. We're gonna re-equip that shield and it looks so much better. Master Link. This treasure chest-like object is a relic of ancient times, left by the goddess for a chosen hero. However, I lack any information on how it can be opened at this time. How unfortunate. You would think that Fee would know how to open it. Oh, more fortune tellers. I don't like fortune tellers. Trust my piercing eyes. I do you no harm. Gaze deeply into my eyes and come close. No thank you. I'm gonna get a potion. If you talk to this shop maiden here, she will give you 1 bottle out of the 5 that you will get in this game. Yes, you get 5 potions, and you get 5 bottles in this game. One of them goes to... You get 3 of them from those kinds of chests that we just saw with Fee. You get 1 in a little bit, and we get 1 for free right here. So you get 5 potions in the game. We get 5 bottles, Now, I've said to the point that I'm only allowed to use 3 red potions. This doesn't mean anything else for later on. Let's use this bottle real quick. Scope. Scope. Okay, really? Why do you not want a scoop, Link? Oh, right. I'm not that bright. Red potions will heal a total of 8 hearts on their current default state. However, you can upgrade potions to make them much more stronger and more prevalent. And as of right now, we're as best suited for adventure as we can be at this point in time. So what we're gonna do is head on off on our journey. Grab another stamina potion and run for our lives. Hopefully Fee won't bug us about this. Roll off and call our amazing bird. Okay, I'm gonna get one thing off about this great sky. I prefer the great sky to the ocean and Wind Waker. A lot of people are going to be thinking I'm nuts for this, but I do. I prefer the music that plays here compared to anything else that happens in Wind Waker. While I do like Wind Waker, I like Skyward Sword's music and choice just a little bit more. The one thing that kind of annoys me about Fee is that she keeps telling me about the cloud barrier, like how you can go through it now. Those birds will often have different kinds of rupees on them. One of them will be the 20, and then there's a silver rupee that they'll hold, and possibly even at times a gold rupee. If you can hit them, you'll get that rupee for free, and you'll get a whole bunch of money for it. And we've landed on the surface. Master Link, we've arrived. This is the fabled surface that has been long part of Skyloft legend. In my calculations, you are currently positioned in a location known as the Sealed Grounds. The Sealed Grounds. Our first area of the game. Please proceed with caution, Master. Will do, Fee. Thanks for looking out for me. Even though I really don't need it. Our first enemies of the game, Deku Babas are rather simple if you can hit them in the way their mouths are positioned. They will go down in one fell swoop. However, you can also do an altered way of taking care of them, being with the Skyward Strike, of course. Share that one so I can show you the way we can do it normally. Which wasn't that way at all. Do that, and do that. However, the hit was totally not on purpose. However, it would seem Link is hallucinating. And the door is not going to open unless we do something about that thing down at the bottom. Now, you could run along this entire path here, but screw that. Even just lightly tapping it before you hit the ground prevents you from getting any fall damage, which is really great. Young one. Child. Destiny, descended from the sky. Raise the sword of the goddess Skyward. Take aim at the evil aura and unleash its power. Master Link, I'm sensing a change in the area that was triggered by your Skyward Strike. I have also detected an aura that correlates closely to your sailcloth. I surmise this aura belongs to Zelda. I can lead you in the direction of this aura through a process known as dowsing. Dowsing? What the fuck is that? Would you like to explain this process to you? Nah. Understood, Master. Dowsing. Short and sweet. I'm not using it. Ever. Except to get rid of the things that like that. Only gonna do that once, and I'm never gonna use it. Why? I've played this game enough to know where everything is at this point. With the exception of probably Gratitude Crystals, which we won't get into much later. So, for that, we're gonna head on up to the top of this place again. We can use these vents to get up there faster, and there are Deku Babas again. Apparently they didn't take too kindly me killing them the first time. I'm gonna go run back up along this way. Best get used to the layout of this place. Trust me, you'll see it again. Okay, this is where? Over here, so let's go this way. Can't climb over gates, unfortunately. I'm gonna try not wasting my stamina. Unlike last time, or like it was that part 3. Don't want to run out of stamina again. Link still has that light jog he's always had from the other 3D Zelda games, but the dashing just makes it so much easier to get around places. Now that we have cleansed that area, the door here will be unlocked. However, we'll go in there next time on Let's Play The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword.